So where's the part?
I saw one.
I seen it. Oh, look, now it lit up and it's all pretty and shit.
Why not just get the part from Guadal?
Why not just steal the part? It's the same as tricking him. Hey, I got gravity back.
I think out of all the blinket stuff, like all the Star Wars there, I think that's still my favorite bit.
Yeah.
How long he goes on about the dumbass.
Well, then what's the point? If you're gonna rig the bet against him,
just steal the
part. Why?
It's like George Lucas thought that Guado's race not being able to be affected by Jedi mind tricks, which I think a number of races.
There's tons.
Yeah. So like he was like that's enough to make this complicated enough for people to just go, okay.
All right, I guess.
I remember as a kid watching episode one going, what's happening?
What is this fuck cop out? Why? Oh, this one guy can't solve the problem the usual way, which is like cheating. Oh, we'll cheat a different way that also uses our powers.
But like, if the whole point of the scene was to keep Anakin's mom on the surface of the planet, but then, like, if that's the only thing, then just don't have this situation at all. Just have her say, like, you don't need to have the complicated bet with Guado. You can just have her be like, I don't want to go to space.
Here
Holy
we go.
Shit. There's just Guado pieces.
Oh!
Ah, that's pretty good. I don't remember that.
It didn't happen at all.
That should happen more.
Yeah. And now it's like,
this guy won't be real.
No, this one's very real.
No, I think he's not real.
He's gonna be not real in a second.
He's gonna disappear any second. Oh.
So yeah, people went to the wiki. It's like, yes, the goddamn Ripper is absolutely just an industrial saw.
Yeah.
It is used as it looks, in the way that it looks.
But why doesn't it have like an extendo arm? Why does it?
Why does it telekinetically
yeah,
do it?
Like that makes it seem more. Because
it's the fucking future.
Okay, why can't it have like a techno arm? From
the
Magra.
Keep me posted.
The hell is that?
That was Strauss in the background.
Okay.
Having a little bad day.
Chuckle.
Hey, I'm Strauss.
A sensible chuckle.
Hey, I'm Strauss, and I'm here to say, oh no, I'm crazy. That's Strauss's new album.
I'm the craziest man in the USA.
Oh, that's good. That's good. So that's where the enemy comes, and that's where the enemy comes.
All right, well, didn't happen last time. So that must mean it'll happen this time.
Come on. Oh, no, they come through the fucking windows.
Or...
let's just... is there something up there? Let's back up in the air, yeah. Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. It's just a fucking child
yeah.
baby, so it's like, you don't even have to get dressed for work.
Oh, right through the windows. And my balls.
No, like, sometimes there's just enemies they throw at you and you're like, I don't even really want to bother.
I actually really appreciate all the items you're giving me.
Yeah. Thanks for, like, helping my cause.
Oh! Uh-oh. God damn it. Oh, wow, both of you just right here,
hey,
huh?
Hey, so if you get bitten in the neck, like a major artery by a necromorph, nothing really happens to you other than you get slightly damaged, yeah?
I don't know, man.
But, like, I thought...
I think you probably turn into, like, a horrible space monster.
No, but judging by Black Man at the start of the game, he got turned into a necro-black man...
instantaneously.
Because Ann Coulter came behind and infected him. With
yeah, the horrible stretched face leather monsters... yes.
That's, but, like, you get
they
all the time.
They, okay, so here's the logic. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Anyone who dies in the range of a marker signal
yeah, okay.
will eventually turn into a necromorph.
Yeah.
The difference is that people that get killed by the necromorph turner things are going to turn in, like, 1 second.
Right, yeah.
Instead of, like...
because when that guy dies, it literally happens like 1 second and a half.
Yeah, and they run around to corpses and they do that.
Always had a problem with the Resident Evil games when you got bit by like mega, like any zombie, and then it's just like eh.
In canon, Chris, Jill, Leon, Claire, Barry, Rebecca, etc., never got bit by one Zombo, ever.
But in gameplay, they get bit by all of the Zombos.
Not if you play the game good.
Yeah, but no one on their first time.
Hell no!
So, therefore...
At the end of the first game of Resident Evil, you went back to town and killed everyone.
Okay, when we played Outbreak, you're infected all the time.
Yeah, those people... Okay, so that one's a little more complex.
They're in the range of the umbrella marker.
They're so what that is, that's your percentage before you get infected because your immune system or whatever. Because it was later revealed in RE7 that at least some of those people totally got out alive.
Yeah, I couldn't believe that.
It used to be like on point they were dead. Period. They did not escape. What the fuck? Everything
in
here.
Yeah, that's
scary. Everything in this fucking place. Why, I swear to God. I swear to fucking God. Get the fuck out of here with that. 5:30?
Do you want to get one more rig before the end of the game, or are you happy with this one?
I'm going to get another rig.
Cool.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm always excited in fashion.
There's
going to
be another
space.
Rig. Yeah.
Fashion space.
Get a lot of fashion in this space. Get these notes. Keep 40K.
Yeah.
Sell this ammo. I don't need that. So what I love about these, so I think, was RE4 the first, like, of these types of games to be like, ammo's gonna drop for the guns you got, period.
Well, it would drop for guns you wouldn't get, like, I never had a TMP in TMP.
No, but what I mean is that it, like, it would self-select so that you would always have enough.
Yeah, maybe. I think that sounds about right.
Yeah, what up? What up now? So that's one of the reasons why the plasma cutter only run is actually so viable. Because, like, 90% of the time, the ammo that drops...
Is plasma cutter ammo.
...is gonna be plasma cutter ammo.
You might want to pause.
Yeah. Unfortunately, someone is trying to get into my house very desperately.
Yeah.
And for some reason could not think to prop open the door for a second or something. Really? You're gonna aim in that direction? That even...
It didn't kill two of them. But they seem like... Oh, I thought you were gonna say they seem like they're not a threat because they're under the thing.
Fucking goddamn.
Under the thing.
I still hear goo. Do you?
Not this time.
You know what I think might have happened? I think some goo might have fallen down there.
I think so too.
It's possible.
But it could have been me.
Well,
they're moving the guy's body.
Wow, these things are really strong.
They have the proportional strength of nothing.
That's crazy. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, it is crazy.
Let's go to the scariest level in Dead Space 1, shall we?
Oh, all right. Isaac. Damn it, that hurts. The bastard bit me.
What?
Yeah, Strauss is bitter.
Shit. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. But he stopped talking. He won't look at me. How's it going at
He's embarrassed.
End? Please tell me this plan.
Sorry,
going to
I
work.
Bit you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. You just look so tasty.
Sorry, I tried to eat your ass.
The wrong way. I don't understand the kids and their new sex stuff.
Yeah. 90% of millennials are like, I'm gonna eat that. What the hell? Nicole's gonna start admonishing Isaac for never eating her ass.
Yeah. That's what's gonna happen.
You put doubt in my mind, Isaac.
You know, I wouldn't have killed myself if I thought I could have escaped for another one of those.
Oh, look.
Why? Why did they use a black light to show off all the necro semen?
It's your apartment.
Eh, you tried.
I did.
Come on. Oh, you.
I thought a bus was coming. There was like a bus, like, horn sound effect was weird.
Oh, come on, guys.
It's fine.
Just, yeah, there we go. Just, yeah, a little bit more of that.
Yeah. Take another sweep.
You fucking assholes. So many of you are attacking me. So many.
Why this room? Why was this room the one where they're like, let's see what's on the floors and walls here, shall we?
I think it's the whole medical deck.
That makes sense.
Yeah. And that's the old little, what do you call it? Fucking...
Thing.
There's a huge fight in there.
Yeah,
back in the
big
day.
Fights.
You know what Dead Space 2 does not have, which I'm very disappointed compared to the first one? Boss fights. It doesn't really have any boss fights. Eat shit, motherfucker.
That like flew to the ceiling. Were they speaking French?
Look at this gooey shit. Look at that.
That'd be hilarious if you dropped it and exploded. I didn't know.
Just leave it there.
Yeah.
That one guy, that was his plan.
You might need it later.
I'm gonna get that, Isaac. Something about that noise when he pulls the panel off that reminds me of something, but I can't quite place it. Hmm. Like some kind of public domain robot noise.
Possibly.
That whole sequence is just him finding
that,
the...
Something's happening.
Hey. Sup, bitch.
That guy's like, wow, you really got me, actually.
Damn, every part... So when you hit somebody with a huge enough explosion, all their arms and legs just fly off.
Well, anything that the character model could get separated.
I like it. I like it when it do. Well, I got a lot of contact beam ammo. I might as well use this fucking thing. Look at that. I have more contact beam ammo than I'd ever need. Ever.
They need to throw more guys. I think the first, like, big open room you did where I put that big, huge monster is, like, a boss fight, I'd say.
Oh, that was a boss fight. You're right.
But you're right in that, like,
here's
that,
our few.
That was one.
Remember that giant monster that took up the entire, like, plant deck?
Yeah.
In Dead Space 1?
Yeah.
That was cool.
You.
Of course, this
now
is playing. Guess what? It's not actually playing.
Yeah, because it's got the yellow lights.
It's got the yellow lights to make
the
Isaac.
The yellow lights of lies.
Yeah. This is where Nicole killed herself, I guess, right?
Keep talking, I'll just collect power ups.
Yeah, man, bitch, get out of my fucking face. I got these power ups to do.
Yeah, power ups first, girls second.
First, you get the power ups.
Yeah.
Then you get the whim.
And see how many power-ups you have.
Yeah, they like it.
Yeah,
get
that
blue power-up.
You need something that gives you +3 stability there.
Yeah. +5 to endurance.
Yeah, endurance. The endurance.
That's the one you're looking for. That's the one that you are personally looking for.
I need like a +10.
Oh, boy.
It's real bad right now.
I can't get through over this evil ladder.
Yeah, it's working with the necklace.
Oh, my God, I blocked myself again.
That's fine.
Oh my God, I blocked myself again!
Put it behind your ass.
Oh man, why has it gotta be like this?
You can put it in front of you and you just assume the physics would be like, oh, just-
It would let it fall down.
Gently fall down like a float.
Oh, I fucking hate this part. That's the gross medical area down there to the left. See that? That is-
That implies someone got crushed.
That's from a monster that Isaac fucking murdered real bad. Okay, well,
like,
we gotta...
I can't believe I'm back here.
I can't believe that it led to this.
Thought it was done. Ow!
Did that kill it?
No.
Nope. But that did.
But it did give it a lot to think about.
This is where the baby enemies showed up for the first time.
Perhaps.
Oh, look! Alien language!
Nice.
Something that will never be gone into ever, because why would a moon need an alien language?
Since you were asking about the conduit earlier, I'll tell you.
Yes, I was.
In the conduit, you had to use a dumb, like, a Kevin Sorbo ball to,
Man, what?
Yeah. To, translate things on the wall, and they're in a weird alien language, and you use the Kevin Sorbo ball to, translate it, and would say it in English for you. I mean, in case you wanted to know, you didn't have to.
Fucking.
But why would you not use the Kevin Sorbo sphere, you know?
The Sorbo sphere? I like that.
Yeah.
You need to calm down, buddy. You need to take a breather.
So there's a lot of electricity.
I can see that.
She'll never defeat.
Oh, wow, look at him. Oh, yeah. I'm
that
gonna stop you.
That guy doesn't have all his limbs cut off. He only has like one, and he's
yeah, but he got horrifically electrified. So hey.
Oh, right. So the necromorph threat is just handled. by electricity.
See, look.
That's all you needed.
Problem solved. One of these used to be a node door.
Not that door. Oh, wait. That,
oh, I wonder what happened in here. Probably good times. Look at these good times.
This was like this before the next.
Yeah, it's kind of awkward. It's like,
We don't talk about what happened that one medical bay.
That one time.
Oh, never.
Man, that thing is fucking cool, man.
Wesley Crusher did that day.
Oh, Wesley Crusher, get the fuck out of here, you fucking asshole.
Get the fuck out of my vernacular. That shouldn't even be a part of it.
I don't want to think about a Wesley Crusher. How about that?
I don't want to think about a Wesley Crusher. Like, it's a type of species.
Did I get both of them? Fucking sick.
I think what we into this day either wears or, like, sells the fucking Christmas sweater that he wore for, like, an entire season. He does something with it. He's aware of it.
I don't know how I feel about Will Wheaton, because he is a Star Trek Next Generation cast member technically, so that gives him a certain level of
panache
and respect and all that shit. But he's also the single worst part of that show in every single episode that he's in. So it's like,
I think it's how they
hey, look, an outdoor.
I think it's how they wrote him. He's also in Stand By Me, the movie.
Yeah.
And he's great in that.
Yeah,
so
but
like it's like,
like in those things, he's supposed to be the fucking Wunderkind, you know?
Yeah, but he's not.
And it's like, and he ends up being like the Wunderkind, and like, do you remember the end of his storyline?
Yeah, the fucking weirdo guy with the weird face just kidnaps him.
Yeah, and he goes off to space. Well, I know they all go.
He was in.
I know, but I mean, he really goes.
Yeah.
And then he goes up to Picard. He's like, you can't steal this land from the Native Americans. Again, Picard. And Picard's like, but I want to.
My orders say that I want to.
And then
to.
He turns into energy.
Picard does.
What a terrible last season that is.
What do you mean?
Remember the one with the masks?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, I do. Hey, holy shit. Netflix released their top 10 most watched episodes of any Star Trek ever.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's watch, let's listen to her.
Nah.
No, it's lame.
Yeah.
So, like, 80% of the list is Voyager, first of all.
Oh, man.
There's not a single Deep Space Nine episode, and of course there's not a single original series. And the two or three Next Gen episodes are like, of course, the best of both worlds, of course.
Of course.
I think both episodes. This is a two-parter. Q Who?
Yeah.
And the other one was The Clues. It was called Clues. But I'm not familiar with that title.
I'm also not familiar with that title.
And I was like, wow, why do millennials like fucking Voyager so much?
Because it's what they grew up with.
Voyager's like a 1998 bunch of, or 1999.
The Voyager's like 1990, a pile of trash.
Whoa.
I remember there was, I know it's 99 at least in that era.
Yeah.
Because there's a Voyager episode in which they fucking get time travel to 1999. In
okay.
It. I'm just gonna do a little backtrack.
It's all accurate.
So I can use those nodes up.
Okay, yeah, I think it was like right here, the bench or something.
There's a bench like a few doors over.
Let's cross the way.
See, right
there
here.
There you go, there's a little bench.
Oh man, Voyager's so bad. Janeway's like a fuck war criminal, it's the worst.
Yeah, we've talked about
it. I know, but people don't know, Matt. They don't goddamn know.
I don't know.
Man, the reload speed on this thing is the absolute fucking worst in the world.
That's not even my, like, when you're like, yeah, you remember that part in Voyager where people turned into lizards and fucked all day and then they got killed?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, no. What?
Okay, this is actually pretty done as well.
Okay.
This is all alt fires.
Yeah, it can be whatever you want.
Alt fire, capacity, width. That's a really good one.
Yeah, I need to extend that.
Pardon?
Voyager's not great.
Voyager is is. I would say that Voyager is in fact extremely poor. All right. Well, that's the most the line gun's gonna get upgraded.
Yeah,
next, the only thing I have left to upgrade is the contact beam and my suit.
Suit, yeah.
So one of my favorite upgrades for the line gun is that it upgrades its width. So yeah, it's extra wide.
Double wide.
Yeah. That's what y'all should be worrying about.
In the traditional Kid Rock
the width.
Style.
I need a pill that makes it wider, but only in one direction. It's like putting in a credit card.
That's the only thing you need to worry about.
Yeah.
I'm worried about this. You should be.
Yeah.
A lot of people are.
You can't fit it into an ATM machine, then you got a problem.
It's useless.
Oh, man. That's weird, the thing that we just talked about.
It's a stat that few people think is important.
No one specced into it, but they were wrong.
Someone has to start specking into the thing that no one else is brave enough to spec into.
It's the only way.
Yeah. It requires pioneers.
Oh, crap. I'm in zero gravity.
Again.
My least favorite gravity.
So I was talking about zero gravity jugs a few episodes ago.
You sure were.
And someone said, well, here's a video. And it's Kate Upton in, like this big turbine thing.
Yeah.
It's, like, a big thing out, like, I guess, like, near NASA or whatever.
Probably and around those space nerds.
Yeah. Because you know the space nerds would be like, you know what's cooler than space travel? Forcing hot broads into zero G in a safe environment.
Yeah. Hey, I bet we could get some broads in here if we tell them it's zero gravity.
Of her just kind of dancing around in zero G. And honestly, it was fine. It didn't blow my mind or anything. I was like, yeah, it seems pretty normal, so I was a little let down. But I do appreciate people putting in the work so I can see zero G jugs.
I appreciate this for you also.
Yeah, that's great.
Ew.
Yeah, you might need that for later. Stow it in your fanny pack.
Another one.
Yeah, I think this entire, section.
So the babies are the ones they usually choose for these sections because they have the attack that works the best, which
and
is
they also
the,
attach near
the
walls.
3-point. They always move around to a wall and then take the 3 prongs out and then prong you.
Yeah, just a little bit of pronging.
Yeah.
Where is it? Oh, they're on that platform.
Here we go. That's a baby. That's a dead baby.
Yeah.
But, like, when you have full control like this, they're not quite as scary.
Yeah. Well, at least he had something going.
So was that all of them?
I felt like there was one more on the platform here.
You're right.
Starboard.
Oh, I missed it.
That's fine. Sounds like they're, throwing nunchucks at you when it whizzes by your head.
They are.
I guess it's a form of nunchuck.
It's a form of fleshy baby nunchucks. You know it. You know, I don't have the patience to go find all the dead bodies of the ones I just, fought.
I don't have the patience to watch you, so that works out.
So, yeah, it does work out. So we're just going to do this. There we go. Oh, look, a fleshy baby penis.
Yeah, I know.
All right, don't say that out loud. Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's a good isolated. I made sure to be quiet.
Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate that.
Well, you made sure to be quiet every time I said, get the child pornography.
Yeah, I was quiet because I was ashamed to be in the room with you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we're going to the central location. Oh, hey. I remember that. That was a memory.
I was literally saying what the text said.
Yeah, over and over and over and over again. Uh-huh.
I said it a couple times.
Oh, yeah. All right. Oh, look. Did you see a little goo monster? I did.
They're just roly-poly-oly in it. They look like a child's, toy. You know, they'd be like the child goo whackers by Galoob, and they would just be like this little goo thing they throw on the ground. They just move by themselves.
Over there.
Like mad balls or something. That's the weird chocobo.
How about you get fucked, chocobo raptor? How about that?
Yeah, it did.
Ah!
Triggered.
That is a barfer. Aha! Guess what, barfer? You're no match for Ripper Chad.
Oh, I'm not. So embarrassed.
Whoa.
More.
So the really good part about the Ripper is that a lot of these guys get stunned by it for some fucking
reason.
Yeah,
because they saw it right before you started using it.
You're right. They saw it. Yeah. Yeah, I tricked you.
They saw the part.
They saw... Wait, hold on.
Yeah, there's something else.
Time for puns in a moment.
We'll get right back to our puns after the break.
I can see you, dude.
We didn't think you could.
What was your plan? Yeah?
I'll go around the side and barf on him. He won't be expecting it at all.
He doesn't have third-person perspective where he can see around corners. That'd be broken.
He can only see, like, things in front of his eyes.
Yeah, man.
Not all the space around him.
What a powerful ability Isaac has. Think about it. All right, let's just keep exploring a little bit. You know, I think there's only one or two of those guys. You know, the guys made out of the different pieces?
Yeah.
I think there's only one or two of them in the whole game. Oh, remember that?
That's fine.
Remember the meteors and shit?
Oh, yes. Oh, shit. Oh, God.
Yeah, that whole sequence.
Yeah, I just went through the entirety of that sequence.
The reason I mention it is because one of them's up there in the first game. I hear another one of those, like, barky chocobo ones, but...
Yeah, but...
I don't see it.
He'll reveal himself when the time is right.
Hey, look. It's the Sprawl.
Cool.